Ephesians chapter 5, the section titled in the NLT, this section is titled Living by the Spirit's Power. Living by the Spirit's Power. We're down in Ephesians 5, verse 17 and 18. Don't act thoughtlessly, but understand what the Lord wants you to do. Verse 18, don't be drunk with wine, because that will ruin your life. Instead, be filled with the Holy Spirit. The words be filled there in the Greek, which is a fabulous, almost perfect language to convey correct thoughts. The words be filled in Greek are in the present passive imperative form. Just think of the words, present passive imperative. Let me tell you what they mean. The present form means if it's in the present, be doing this. If it's in the present, then be being filled. It means to be filled, be being filled, and continually be being filled. Anytime it's the present, anytime you come to your senses and go, oh, it's the present, I need to be filled with the Holy Spirit again. That's what present means. Passive means you only receive it. Passive, as opposed to active. You don't do anything, you just receive. So if it's the present, receive being filled with the Holy Spirit. Now, right? You get it. If it's the present, be being filled with the Holy Spirit. Imperative means it's a command. It's a command. It's not a suggestion. It's not an option. It's a command. If it's present, be being filled with the Holy Spirit. And why does the Holy Spirit compare us being filled with the Holy Spirit to being drunk with wine in verse 18? You see it? Why compare it, or contrast is the more accurate word. Why contrast being filled with the Holy Spirit to being drunk? Because I'm not suggesting this, but you probably already know, if you will continually fill yourself with alcohol, how much of your life will it affect? 1,000%, 100% times 10. Everything you think, every action you take, every reaction, every response, everything about you will be completely affected by the alcohol that's continually poisoning your system. In a similar but contrasting way, if you are continually being filled with the Holy Spirit, then everything about your life will be affected, will be impacted. How you think will be affected by the Holy Spirit, how you act, how you react, how you respond to people. It will all be according to the Holy Spirit that is continually being poured into your life. You get it? Oh, man, that's good.